Minister for Climate Resilience and the Environment, Senator Simon Steele, says Grenada was a leader in discussions on the head table as major achievements were reached, including the historic move to phase down the use and production of coal, as well as the support via financial subsidies for fossil fuels.
Where we were disappointed was the area of loss and damage. And loss and damage speaks to those areas that go beyond adaptation. A hurricane, we cannot stop a hurricane, but what we can do is minimize the losses that are incurred during such an event, how we can accelerate our recovery coming out of that, and the resources that are required to enable us to address that, including some of the slow onset impacts, such as sea level rise. This is, again, a highly contentious issue. Developed countries who are responsible for the challenges that we face are reluctant to move this agenda forward. We were able to progress that agenda, but not to the to the level vulnerable countries, developing countries, wanted.
Steele says keeping the target of 1.5 degrees Celsius alive is a major decision coming from COP26, and it boils down to the actions countries around the world have to take to reduce global warming above pre-existing industrial levels.
Global warming is currently at 1.1 degrees. Remember, that magic number is 1.5, but we're on a trajectory to actually hitting 2.7 degrees by the end of this century, which will be devastating not only for us, but for all countries.
He notes significant to the climate conference are the effects climate change has had on developing and vulnerable nations such as Grenada compared to the 20 countries that contribute 80% of greenhouse gas emissions. The minister said that while the problem lies with these countries, so do the resources to tackle the issues of climate change.
But recognizing that target 1.5 with universal acceptance of that was a major step forward. The call for greater ambition, greater action by all, recognizing the science was a critical component. There are some countries that are more progressive, far more aware as to what is happening and what needs to be done than others. But there was almost universal acceptance of the science and the actions that are required.
Minister Steele says the doubling of adaptation finance up to $40 billion for countries such as Grenada, which is one of the two elements critical to taking action, was one of the important decisions taken at COP26. Mitigating the effects of climate change is the next key element. I am Gerard Joseph for GBN News.